Okay, so I was struggling with this yesterday. So basically, I've got a few sequences set up here. You know, I brought these over from the MPC. They're just template beats that they provide, and I've kind of edited them, you know, pulled different elements out to kind of make them different. So I've just got an intro. I've got beats with no bass and a main beat. So if you've never sequenced in the actual MPC app itself, it's a little confusing, so I want to walk you through that. Something I found is modes really determine how you interact with the software. And it's important to kind of, you know, be aware of those things. To edit a song, you have to go into song mode. And at the same time, sometimes if you want to do something in the pads or program edit, it's best to go into these modes. And just think of them in terms of the modes on your MPC. It's the same idea, it's just a totally different layout. I just take these sequences, and again, I'm not really showing you how to make a song, I just have to do this to actually explode the drums, which is the main focus of this tutorial. So I'm going to take an intro up here. First, I'm going to name the song. We're just going to call it Pad Exploder, just so that we know this is our test. It's not something we've actually created that we want to save. And then I'm just going to start inserting steps. We want to select the beats we want. I'm going to do intro, just real quick, insert step. Then we go to up here again. You know, maybe I want beats with no bass, right? Insert step. And then I want the main beat. We're going to insert that step. And then just to finish it off, we'll have beats with no bass. Insert that. Again, not really trying to make a... Oh, that's interesting. Okay, so something you'll see here that's happened is we've imported the incorrect sequence. It's really easy to change if you go here. So, like, we wanted the intro. Just select that. That's your intro. And you can tell it to repeat, you know, however many times. If you want two sections of intro, you could do that. I'm doing as little as possible so we don't spend a lot of time processing information when we go to export this thing. We go to beats, no bass, then the main beat, and then again, beats, no bass. Okay, so you have this song. You want to export it to, say, Ableton, but you want the kick, the snare, hi-hat, all to be separate. We have to go through kind of a convoluted process to get it to that point, but this works for me, so I'm just showing you what works for me. It's not necessarily the way to do it. It's what other people taught me, and it's what I am currently finding works. Now, if I find something that works better in the future, I'll update the video, and we can talk about that. So yeah, we have this song sequence. What we want to do is convert it to sequence. What that's going to do is actually take all of the entire song and make it one sequence that'll then show up here. So I'm going to take this, the song Pad Explorer, and we're going to convert to sequence. We want to make sure it's kind of going on the end of our sequences here. You could also do, sometimes I like to use a number that I can remember easily. So like you could do lucky number 7, you could do 10. And part of the advantage of that too is if you do have to go back and edit sequences, you have empty sequences you can enter things into. But let's just do 10. This is really important actually. Include muted tracks or ignore muted tracks. You have to be careful here because if you've set up, you know, the way I build songs in MPC is I'll build a whole beat and the first measure will be just kick. And then there might be like a kick and a hi-hat and a kick and a hi-hat and a snare. So you do want to do ignore muted tracks because otherwise it's going to turn all those back on and you're going to have a nightmare on your hands. You do not want to do that. So now I've created this new sequence. If I go up to my sequences, Pad Exploder, not Explorer. You know what, let's actually get out of this mode. Let's go to our main mode. Go to, from song one, Pad Exploder. Now notice when I zoom out of the sequence, we now have the entire progression. Now the cool thing about this too is now that you have, oh wait for her to stop. The cool thing about this is that now that you have, you know, the whole song here, if you did need to tweak one or two hits, or like say I don't want, there's this clip that plays back. Yeah. So say like I don't want that to play for a measure or two. I'll just take it out. So now just the bass comes in, right? A lot nicer. All right. Now that we've got this kind of set up, what we're going to do is take this sequence, and I want to export it, but if we go to export, let's see if this actually, you know, gives us the options we want. Go to export, audio mixdown. Oh, and it is giving us the explode tracks option. Now, the problem with this is it's going to explode the tracks, but what tracks are available? So you'll notice here, there's only track one. And what we want is we want a different track for each element in the drum kit. Now, I don't recommend doing this until you're ready to export a project, until a project is like ready to really go over to Ableton, because then you're kind of committing. And this applies to like, you know, anything from Fruity Loops to Reason to Pro Tools. Same process, same idea. This is for your mixdown and for additional sequencing you want to do in Ableton. So you're kind of committing when you do this. I would also save this as a new project just to be safe, because versioning, it might cost you a little bit of extra space, but it's negligible in 2022 when hard drives are so cheap. So just save everything, save a new version, protect the old version before you start exploding things. There may be a way to take it backwards. I've not found it, and I imagine it would be a big pain in the butt to have to figure that out. So instead of that, just deal with it. Make a version, protect yourself. So we've got this track. We want to explode it. There's a few ways to do this. If we go to edit track, and then we go down to track, you'll see there's a bunch of options here. One of them is explode. Let's hit that now. Ah, yep, there we go. So all of the kits, and I think it only saves the kits that we're actually utilizing. It's only, I believe, taking kit pieces that we're actually playing. So if you're not playing something on like the 15 or 16 pad, it's not going to split that. The nice thing about that is when you bring in the Ableton, there's not going to be a bunch of empty audio tracks taking up room. So yeah, we have all of those exploded. Now what should happen, should I say, because you know, sometimes things don't go the way you want them to. Go to export, audio mixdown. Now you have this explode tracks option, right? I think you can also, oh no, okay, it only gives you one option here. You can only pick one, but you could do a stereo output separately. You can choose your file format. I like to do 24 or 48 usually. Some people like 96. I don't know. It saves room, and unless I'm doing ambient or field recordings or something that really needs that 96, I feel like for beat based stuff, I'm usually at 48. 24, I feel like, is important though. I like a higher bit depth. So, you know, again, maybe you like 32-bit float point. That's your option. I'm just telling you what I like. I like 24 or 48. And that's what I usually use. So I'm just going to my tutorials folder, and I'm going to save it, you know, in somewhere that makes sense. We're doing an MPC-1 tutorial on drum exploding. Just going to call it drum exploder. Do it. And this will just be called drum exploder. And now it's going to export all those tracks. Again, the reason I did a short sequence was because I wanted to, you know, just take the time showing you how this works. If I bring up my my kit, here we go. And you can see all of my different audio files here. Let's see what those sound like. There's the bass. But do we have the question is, do we have all the parts? And you'll see we have kick, clap, hi-hat, another hi-hat, shaker, percussion. So like the kick. Yep, it's nice and isolated. Cool. And then you can just bring those into your DAW, you know, be it Pro Tools, Ableton, whatever, and sequence them. One thing to remember is when you bring it into Ableton, turn automatic wave warping off, or your stuff's all going to be completely, you know, out of sync. So make sure that that's turned off and that your stuff is all starting at the one. But yeah, that's how to explode drum pads from the MPC-1. Kind of a pain in the butt, but once you know how to do it, it's pretty easy. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to click subscribe and follow the channel for more of this type of content, as well as DJ mixes and new tracks I'm putting out. Thanks a lot.